name is Justine O'Leary, and I'm on the Winterfest committee as a volunteer, and I'm also a certified yoga instructor. So I'm really excited to be here with you to offer a 30-minute gentle hatha yoga practice. So this gentle hatha class is designed for all different yogis. You do not need to have experience, and it's a class that's all about relaxation and stretching your body. So for this class, we're going to get started in child's pose. You're going to come back to sit towards your heels, bring your knees to the outside edges of your mat, and bring your fingertips towards the front of your mat. The goal is to take your forehead and press it into the mat. And if your glutes are up a little bit high, that's totally okay. Start to settle into this now here experience. Take a deep breath in and a long breath out. Take a deep breath in and a long breath out. One more time. Fill your belly with air. Take a deep breath in and a long sigh out. Let your armpits melt into the mat and connect your mental body into the earth. And gently rock your forehead from side to side. We're dedicating our practice tonight to gratitude. So every breath you take as you inhale, you're going to think, I am grateful for. And as you exhale, you will think of one thing that brings you gratitude, makes you grateful for life. Showing your body kindness and compassion. Tabletop. So your knees are stacked above your knees are stacked below your hips. Your wrist is in line with your shoulders. And you're gently pushing the ground away from you in your tabletop. Engaging your core. We're going to take some gentle cat-cows. We're going to inhale, push the ground away from you, bring your chest towards the ceiling. And as you exhale, you're going to look towards your belly button, spreading your shoulder blades as wide as possible. Inhale, look up, open up your heart center, and exhale, round in the shoulders, looking towards your belly button. As you breathe in, I am, and as you exhale, grateful. Connection with your breathing. Notice every inhale, every exhale. It's okay to take time for you. It's okay to take time for silence and for space. Breath in, exhale. Downward facing dog. energetically push the ground away from you with your palms. Your fingertips are spread nice and wide. You're looking towards your feet. And you can bend your knees if you're feeling tightness in your hamstrings. You can bend them as much as you need to. And bringing your chest towards your thighs. Relax your face, your jaw, and your throat. And as you inhale, I am. And as you exhale, grateful. Taking your deep belly breaths, in through your nose, out through your mouth. Step through to a seated position. Bring both feet forwards. And you're going to slowly lower down to the floor, vertebrae by vertebrae. Hug both knees into your chest. Show your body some love, some gratitude. Same love that you would show a small child, perhaps your pet. You deserve that love too. And gently massage the lower back by rocking from side to side. Maintain your connection to your breath. Inhale, I am. Exhale, grateful. Inhale to center. Exhale to the side. Baby pose. You're going to flex both of your feet. You're going to touch your toes, your shins, or the backs of your thighs, and you're going to move from side to side. Whatever allow you touch the part of your body that allows your lower back to remain pressed into the mat. And you'll take any expression of full happy baby that feels good to you. You can extend your left leg, come back to center, extend your right leg, whatever feels good, you can explore. Yoga doesn't have to be serious, you can be relaxed and still have fun. Inhale to center, exhale right leg out, inhale to center, exhale to the side. Excellent work. Release your left leg down to the mat. You're going to take your right foot or your right shin or the back of your right hamstring, whatever feels good, for half happy baby. You're bringing that right knee towards the floor. In this class tonight, we're really targeting your lower back and your hips. Remember to be calm. bring your right knee across your body for supine twist. Your right knee comes across your body. You're going to bring your right arm out to the side like an airplane wing. And you're going to look over your right shoulder. We're going to start to make snow angels. You're going to bring your right arm up towards the wall behind you as you inhale. And as you exhale, you're going to lower towards the wall by your feet. Inhale, I am. Exhale, grateful. Maybe thinking of what you're grateful for. Or if you're just grateful overall, that's good too. Dynamically moving your arm, just like a snow angel. Inhale and exhale. Slowly come back to center and hug both knees into your chest. Rock from side to side. Notice any change you may be feeling between your right and left side. Happy baby pose. And stay in your happy baby pose, or you can rock from side to side if that feels good to you. The smile comes to your face and you're happy baby, that's okay. Sit with it. If you don't feel like smiling, that's okay too. As you take that deep breath in, and you think, I am, and as you exhale, grateful. Extend that gratitude to your body for what it can do. Release your right leg down to the mat for half happy baby. Maintain your connection to your breathing. Deep breath in. Long breath out. Gently take your left knee. You're going to bring it across your body for supine twist. Your left arm comes out like an airplane wing, palm facing the ceiling. And you're going to look over your shoulder at your left palm. And make our snow angel. Inhale, I am. Exhale, grateful. grateful for the simple things in our life. It can be the laugh of a child, the way the snow looks, the way the sun shines. It can have a dramatic impact on our happiness. Finding something that we're grateful for, even on the hardest days, can really have a positive impact on our lives and our well-being. Look for one thing. Come back to center. Hug both knees into your chest. Massage that lower back. Rocking side to side. Right foot to your left thigh for figure four stretch. If this doesn't feel comfortable for you, you always have an option to leave your foot on the mat, and for some people that will be enough stretch, and that's perfectly okay. If it's not enough of a stretch, you're going to reach in through the triangle and pull your knee in towards your chest. And you can rock from side to side again here. Feel for any spots of tension in your hip, and you can stop there and hold it. Connecting again with your breath. Deep breath in. Deep breath out. Feels good to your body on each exhale. You can bring your knee a little closer towards your chest. Figure four stretch, opposite side. So your left foot is dorsiflexed. So this is my foot pointed. This is my foot dorsiflexed. So your left foot is dorsiflexed on your thigh. You're gonna reach in through the triangle, and your goal is to bring your knee in towards your forehead. Again, the option is always there to have your right foot on the mat. You could get a good enough stretch from that. That's totally okay. Side to side, find the point of tension and then hold. Inhale, I am. Exhale, grateful. Both knees into your chest. And bring both feet to the outside edges of your mat. And your knees are going to come together. Reclined pyramid pose. So you'll likely feel this pose stretch in your lower back. This is a great exercise to stretch that lower back. Ground down, connect this now here experience. Feel your body as it touches the floor. You're safe here. You're supported. Following our breath, you're going to bring your knees to the side on your exhale. Inhale, back to center. Windshield wiper your knees back and forth. Both knees into your chest one more time. Rock from side to side. Massage that lower back. Tabletop position. We're going to take cat cows. Inhale, open your heart to the sky, energetically pushing the ground away from you. Exhale, looking towards your belly button, spreading your shoulder blades nice and wide. On your next exhale, your final downward facing dog. Relax your face, your jaw, and your throat. Take a deep breath in and a long sigh out. Take a deep breath in. Feel all the stress that you felt from today. And exhale, sigh out, releasing that stress. Deep breath in, one more time. Sigh out. Gently walk your dog, bringing your left heel towards the ground, back to center, right heel towards the ground. Bend your knees, come back to tabletop, and make your way to a seated position. gentle hack the class. So for the final 5 minutes, you're going to take a 2-minute gratitude meditation. This is a mantra style meditation. So what will happen is I will let you know when we start. I'll give you instructions on the mantra, and then after 2 minutes, I'll bring you out of the meditation. You have the option to stay seated, or if it's more comfortable, you can always lie down for your meditation and you can switch positions at any time. Ground down through the sit bones, through your sit bones. Roll your shoulder blades down your back. Connect to the natural rhythms of your breath. If you want to feel grounded energy, place your palms on your knees. And if you want to accept energy from the universe, open your palms up to the sky. Take a deep breath in and a long breath out. Feels comfortable for you, you can close your eyes, relax your face. If you feel any judgment, release the judgment. If your mind wanders, that's normal, it's totally okay. Just come back to your breath, come back to your mantra. We'll take 3 deep breaths. In through your nose and out through your mouth. For your 2-minute mantra meditation, as you breathe in, you will say to yourself, I am grateful for. And as you exhale, you will think of one thing. This mantra meditation will last 2 minutes. If at any time you lose track, it's okay. Just come back and meet yourself where you're at. And then find a new something to be grateful for with each exhale. Your 2 minutes of mantra meditation start. Your mantra meditation. Keep your eyes closed if it feels good for you. And if you haven't lowered down to your mat yet, gently lower yourself down for your final shavasana. You can have both feet extended. extend it onto the ground, or you can stay in reclined pyramid if it feels better for your lower back. Rest here for your final 2 minutes, your gentle hatha relaxation class. You deserve this time. You deserve this silence and this space. Visualize yourself in a pool of gratitude. Pretend that you were floating, completely weightless. Relax your face, your jaw, and your throat. Roll over onto your left side. Bring some gentle awareness back into your body. You can hang out here in child's pose. In fetal position. Feel the gratitude that's flowing through your body. Slowly make your way up to a seated position. Take a deep breath in and a long sigh out. Bring your hands to Anjali Mudra. From my heart to your heart, with gratitude and love, namaste.